Hi, you're listening to China Blue on WSB 90.1 FM. I'm Jackie, and with me today here.
Hi, I'm Jessica.
And hi, I'm Betty.
Today we are talking about TikTok and Chinese social media. So are you guys familiar with TikTok?
Yeah.
Very.
Do you guys find yourself often on the app?
Every day.
Same.
Every day?
Probably as much as I sleep.
What kind of content do you guys watch?
Well, I'm mostly on Asian talk and food talk, so.
Well, mine's like really random. I just anything on my For You page.
Yeah, I feel like TikTok has a lot of content. It's like there's a variety of stuff for like everyone. And I feel like it's just another form of social media.
Yeah, I think, I like how it's like formatted in like 50 seconds, like videos. But it's just really fast, and like I have like, and I guess like that's why now I can't like focus on stuff.
True. I mean, like, I like that it's 60 seconds, it gets straight to the point, but sometimes 60 seconds are too long.
Right? I wish like lectures were like that short.
Like, for some of these TikToks, they're like within 5 seconds, I know if I want to watch it or not. So, like, I would just skip after 5 seconds.
Like, how might I just scroll through?
I feel like one of the appeals is the short videos, and it's like entertaining too, and you just want to like keep watching.
Yeah.
You guys like watch when you're eating, or?
Yes, I watch when I'm eating, brushing my teeth, while I'm studying sometimes.
Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was just gonna say that I watch it when I'm like at the end of the day.
To like cool off.
Yeah.
Do you guys watch it to procrastinate?
Yeah. It's just that sometimes I just don't want to study, so I would just go on TikTok, and then once I go on, I don't get off until like a couple of hours.
Do you guys know about the TikTok challenges?
Yes, like some of them, but I haven't seen any recent ones lately.
I haven't seen like any. What are these challenges?
I've seen the ones where it's like there's a, like a little clock formation that they put on TikTok, and it tests your flexibility.
No.
So if you go some like your leg goes up for like 0 o'clock to like 12 or something, I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, like with your body?
Yeah.
It's like the hands of the clock?
Yeah.
I have not seen that.
I mean, I've seen some challenges, like the most recent one that I could think of is probably the WAP.
Oh. I think there's another one that's pretty recent. It was like testing your center of gravity between guys and girls. But I don't have to describe it. It's like you kind of like crouch down on the ground, and then like
yoga stuff.
Oh, kind of, yeah. Apparently, like for most of these videos, like the girls succeed and the guys end up falling back to the ground.
What do you guys think of TikTok as like another form of social media where people just like can express themselves?
I think it's pretty good. I usually don't focus too much on a lot of social medias, but I feel like TikTok, it's actually like ones that I'm mostly on, because like they range from like a lot of topics from like social justice or just entertainment, and I feel like it's a really good way of getting like a summary of what's going on during whatever times that's occurring.
Yeah, I feel like it's just like a really inclusive platform, because like paying for like other social media like platforms like Instagram is like really it's really like pretty much exclusive to like influencers and people who are like celebrities or like already have like those following. But then for TikTok, it's like you could just be like a normal average person, and you could just make content, and like, people see it and they like it. Yeah,
I mean, a lot of influencers also have TikTok too. And it just, I think it's just another way for them to, you know, to spread their influence. Do your relatives or parents know about TikTok?
Well, my parents don't know what TikTok is, but they use the Chinese version, which is called Douyin. I think they were actually on that before I even joined TikTok, to be honest. Mm-hmm. I remember my parents would be just watching, like, Douyin, and, like, people, I don't know if this was a thing back then, but there's like a bunch of people singing karaoke on TikTok. I don't know, but my mom, dad thought it was hilarious for some reason.
Like, in my family, like, everyone has, like, the Douyin, and that's why my brother has, like, TikTok.
But you got, your parents have, like, the Chinese version of the app?
Yeah, they had it, like, before I downloaded TikTok, and they watched, like...
Wait, can you still download the app, the Douyin?
I think you can only do it if you have a VPN.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Okay. All right. I guess we're going to go into our music break now.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be back.
You are my only. 人快滚蛋 Lady 你被我给霸占 Baby 跟我在一起吧再靠近一点想见你一面我爱你这句话能不能让我再讲一遍再靠近一点想见你一面看到你就笑出了我身上所有的疲倦再靠近一点想见你一面我爱你这句话能不能让我再讲一遍再靠近一点想见你是爱上这种恋爱般的体验
我让天地焕然一下灿烂我让年华猛然一下慌乱我让空气虽然一下粗软整个地球悠然围着我转我让小鸟欣然围着赞叹我让花朵嫣然围着摇颤我让鱼儿跃然围着追赶瑟瑟抱残当然万物喜欢我让矜持怦然撩起波澜我让麻木傲然撩起梦幻我让人们飞然撩起呐喊哎呀妈呀天哪怎么办我怎么这么好
千钧一发可逼真方向对你看着弯又大又远想去就要去几杯你看着面又长又宽不下小说看流泪从来不相信魔鬼有时生活特别累别想大碗宽面别流泪这碗大千万别虚荣心作祟真心话 说话，不想给你机会，先别怼，就散了吧。听完这首歌就洗洗睡。
我这一生漂泊四海，看淡了今朝，月高高的挂无暇。人生能有几次机会相聚，甚是少，轻易别轻易放掉。才是真谛，所以何必针锋相对，你看着弯又大又远，想聚就要聚几杯，你看着面又长又宽，感觉镜花水月，我一生笑傲江湖，我只身闯江湖，何必分出胜负。这碗大千万别虚荣心作祟，真心话说话，不想给你机会，先别怼，就散了吧。听完这首歌就洗洗睡。
我这一生漂泊四海，看淡了今朝，月高高的挂无暇。人生能有几次机会相聚，甚是少，轻易别轻易放掉。
掌上的蝴蝶飞走了吗？
飞走了吗？
白云是蓝天，正在放的风筝，青春是操场能跑的我们，不要担心受伤，勇敢的朝梦想闯一闯。
Welcome back. Now we're going to talk about Chinese social media. And I guess one of the oldest social medias is QQ. I don't know if you guys heard of it.
I used to play with QQ. I never had the account though. Like I would just go on my parents' account to play Chinese poker and know about it. Yeah.
It's called like Doditu, right?
Yeah.
There's like a app you could play like a lot of games with QQ. Mm-hmm. But you never used it for like messaging other people?
No, because like back then I think I was probably in elementary school when QQ was a thing, but
yeah.
All my friends used like Facebook, so I didn't really contact anybody through QQ. What about you, Jessica?
I've just never used it, but I know it is kind of.
Yeah, I used it in elementary school because a lot of my friends used QQ to communicate with others with me. I don't know what happened to QQ, but it kind of just faded out and no one uses it anymore.
Isn't like QQ kind of incorporated into WeChat? Because I saw like you can access QQ games on WeChat.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. I was gonna ask, do you guys use WeChat?
For me, I do use WeChat, but not as often as I use American social media, since the majority of my friends do use American social media. But I've used WeChat mostly for like work, and then I used it a lot last semester since I took a Chinese class here. So we had a group chat with the professor on WeChat, and then.
Oh, you guys had a WeChat with your professor?
Yeah, like she actually added me on WeChat.
Okay.
And then I also pretty much just use WeChat to like video chat my grandmother, and that's about it, I think. Yeah, so it's just work and school, mainly.
Yeah, I just don't use WeChat either.
You don't even use WeChat at all?
No, I like communicate with people. I just use Facebook Messenger because that's like what most people have. I also use like the Messenger thing on Instagram. Like that's it.
Yeah, or, like, I mean, I use WeChat because we have like a group family chat for my relatives at China. So we have like a group chat for that, and you know, that's about all I use WeChat for. Also, WeChat has like this transaction system. You know, you can send like red envelopes on Chinese New Year. So that's what we also do.
Yeah, my family does that too. My family actually has a family chat on WeChat. I'm just not in it. because they all text in Chinese and I'm not confident in my skills to communicate with people in Chinese. And a lot of them are like relatives from like in China, so I haven't really ever seen them, so it'd be awkward to talk to them. But yeah, my family loves sending red envelopes. Like for my mom, it's like I guess it's like a FOMO. Like every time she hears WeChat go off, because I think WeChat has their own like notification sound.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh my god, that is a hongbao. I need to collect it. Hurry up and help me collect it.
Sure.
And but it was mostly between her friends, like from high school and family. Yeah.
Are you guys fluent in Chinese?
Not very. I'm a ABC. Like I understand it, but communicating is a little work. Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah. I can like speak and understand it, but I can't like read and write.
Yeah. I feel like I can read and write better than I can communicate.
I'm going back to the WeChat with your professor. Do you guys have like a group chat in the WeChat? Like with the class?
Yeah, everybody was in it and she would type in Chinese or like send, you know, like WeChat has this voice message option. She would just speak in Chinese to send it to us. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm already overwhelmed.
Would she send like reminders or like homework instructions?
Yeah, or like this is the breakdown for the week or like how to do certain homeworks. But she would say it all in Chinese or type it all in Chinese, yeah.
That's really interesting. I didn't think like professors would use WeChat to communicate with their students. Like usually they would use like Piazza or like Blackboard.
I think Piazza is mostly for CS students.
Yeah.
Yeah, but for my class, because it was asynchronous, so I think people wanted an easier way to contact her. So because like I think she had a time difference than us, so it was hard to contact her, so we would just use WeChat.
Wait, on WeChat, isn't it linked to your phone number?
Yeah.
So can other people see your phone number?
I don't think so. Like, because if they wanted to call you, they could just call you on WeChat instead of like actually calling your phone.
Oh. On WeChat, you know, in China, WeChat is like really popular. And they have this thing called WeChat Pay where people can just pay with WeChat. It's like it's sort of like Apple Pay.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that? I've
actually seen something like that in the city, which was kind of surprising because I never seen like any other places use WeChat Pay. Because I knew it was a thing in China because China was like really big on like using your phone to pay for things. But I think in Flushing at Skyview Mall or something, they had a karaoke like room, and then they gave you an option to pay by WeChat, I think.
Oh, like you could just scan a QR code, right?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I didn't know like you could WeChat pay in the US. I thought it was only exclusive in China.
Yeah, see, that's why I was really surprised when I saw it.
Yeah, I was like really surprised when I went to China and like you could literally just like use that like anywhere and like it's just really convenient because like you don't have, I don't think you had to like change the currency, like do you?
I think you just use yuan, is it?
Like it just converts automatically, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Like a credit card.
Wait, so when you went to China, like everyone was using WeChat Pay?
Like my family has it, like I don't, but like my family has it and that's what they use to like pay for stuff. And it was like really convenient because like you just have to like bring your phone with you. You don't need like your wallet or a credit card or like cash or anything. Like people always have their phone on them, so.
Does most of the store have it or is it just the big stores?
I felt like most of the stores had it because, like, everywhere we went, like, there would be, like, a sign at the, like, cashier place that, like, you could scan. Yeah.
Also, even, like, small convenience stores had a system for it?
Like, I don't know, like, how small are you talking about? I mean, like, I don't think, like, the stalls at, like, the street stalls have it, but, like, And it was like this kind of like small-ish store that like had it too.
Okay.
I think there was another really popular way to pay in China. I think it was Alipay or something.
That's another form of social media, is it?
I'm not sure, but I know it's similar to WeChat Pay.
Alipay. Sort of like PayPal.
Yeah, I think something like that.
Why do you think WeChat is so popular amongst Asian communities?
Probably really popular since like for a lot of families, their relatives are still in China, and it's the easiest way to contact them would be through WeChat. I remember when I was younger, before WeChat became a thing, like my grandmother or my mom would have to go to like these Chinese stores to buy like a phone card thing. So then you would have to spend money to talk to people.
Yeah. And they would like call in the morning. They'll call at night or in the morning because of the time difference.
I share a room with my grandma, like every time, like when I was like a kid, like I'll always hear her like calling someone like while I'm like getting ready to sleep.
Yeah, and I also feel like because of the phone card, you only had like a certain amount of time to talk to people on the phone. So that's why people probably like the WeChat a lot better, since there's no like cap on how long you want to spend with your relatives. You can actually see them like through the camera.
Yeah. I feel like
Go ahead.
Wait, I'm not sure, but like was WeChat like created for like people like in China, like you know? Or like was it just
like, I think WeChat incorporated QQ.
I think that's why like because it's like kind of made for like people who are like Chinese to like communicate with each other, while like other platforms, like you can still communicate with people like who live like overseas, but like maybe it's like just not as convenient because it wasn't like, you know,
I was gonna say how like WeChat is sort of cuts down the expense of like talking and communicating with your relatives in China.
Right. And for me, I think another reason why WeChat was pretty popular is because like in China there's like a firewall, so you're not allowed to use a lot of certain types of social media. So I know WeChat has like kind of like a Facebook wall, I think it's like called Life Moments or something like that, and then that you can share with your family so they can see what's going on with your life. And I think that's the only way that people can see what you post abroad.
It's like a timeline, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because like there's like a lot of like censorship in like China, so like there's social media platforms you could use like here that you can't use in China. It's like really hard to communicate with like relatives, but, like. I mean, WeChat is like accepted in China, so.
Yeah, I guess that's the reason why WeChat is like sort of like the only communication because of the censorship.
Yeah, I remember like WeChat was almost banned in the US. And then my parents were like, really upset because that's literally like the only way to contact people abroad. So we tried to transition to LINE. Just in case WeChat did get banned, it was a lot of work.
Yeah, I think there's two different versions of WeChat. There's like a version for China and there's a global version.
Oh yeah, and I think the China one is called WeSing or something like that.
Yeah.
And WeChat also has like a lot of news that I don't know about you guys, but my parents, they get like the news from WeChat. Is that like the same for you guys?
Yeah, sometimes they look at that a little too much. I remember when I was younger, my mom was like, oh my gosh, bubble tea, you can't drink bubble tea. Like, haven't you just seen on the news on WeChat that if you eat too much tapioca, it's going to give you cancer.
It's going to stay in your intestines and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, like you can't really, like, criticize them for that because, like, even for, like, younger people, like, they go on social media. Like, they get most of their news from, like, social media and, like, they trust those sources. But, like, you know, those aren't credible sources.
Yeah. I feel like WeChat has so much, like, people just can post whatever news they want and sort of misleading sometimes. Mm-hmm. Do you guys know any other forms of social media, the Chinese social media?
Not really. I think it's just mostly WeChat and QQ that I know of.
Yeah, WeChat
and QQ. My parents don't really use anything else because they're not very technologically savvy.
Yeah, WeChat and QQ are from the same company, Tencent. I guess this is it. I don't think there's any more to talk about. Thank you guys for listening. Make sure to follow our Instagrams for the latest updates and make sure to attend the upcoming events. See you guys next week. Bye.
Real. 个傻瓜，但我并不爱他，我想忘记妈妈，这世界太麻烦，我不知道咋办，无法逃离周围全是 free friend， 陷入循环的背叛，欠我的不需要他归还，我的灵魂早已溃烂。 You take all my world with rubbish、yeah. I'm like trapper in my wish、啊、总是开不了口，不能安慰你，我的心也请你带走。 My bitch， 用我总是我自己，想法犯得起，我只是不确定爱与不爱你，我懒得分析。 I'm like J， 我不会拦截，还会发神经，想不停呼吸，吸引他注意。 Just you and me， baby， 我想早点睡。背对背看不到我的 blue face， 当我倒了霉，认清了他的鬼，不安将我包围，我像一个风吹抓他，我像一个傻瓜，但我并不爱他，我想忘记世界太麻烦，我不知道咋办，无法逃离周围全是 free friend， 陷入循环的背叛，欠我的不需要他归还，我的灵魂早已溃烂。
我在你计划之外，谁又被你淘汰，我爱你我直接留待，谁是绝无淘汰，注定没出息、啊、现在已经二十几，和你不能比，哥们全部告诉己。
抓他，我像一个傻瓜，但我并不爱他，我想忘记妈妈，这世界太麻烦，我不知道咋办，无法逃离周围全是 free friend， 陷入循环的背叛，欠我的不需要他归还，我的灵魂早已溃烂。
观察大自然的现象，从太阳直到月亮，一切都那么的坚强，疲惫到抬不起肩膀，你是否能把我原谅，暂时把眼睛闭上，这座城市有我们的理想，但也是伤心的地方。 Tell me how you feeling about the city， Tell me how you feel the night， Tell me how you feeling about the city，Keep counting what you are time. Tell me how you feeling about the city. Tell me how you feel the night. We're feeling about the city. So fascinating, but not alright. But not除了时光机器，但是为何都想回到过去，没人期待往前，对过去也只是留恋，只能偶尔碎语两句，哎呀想当年。在21世纪开头生产的香水依旧浓郁，就算保质期也只有2年，而如今有人为了上床居然能够说出我真的爱你这种谎言。受伤的白鸽用剩下的全部羽毛做了笔交易，才能留色和平饭店。我们总在每一次犯错后承诺自己将来一定能够改头换面，这件事可笑又同样的矛盾，就像醒酒茶碰上了午后的断片。我们全都知道，我们全都明白，但你问我的话抱歉我没看见。人们变得更加容易迷路，但手机导航变得更加精确，直到有天舞台上面有了女孩，上海路再也没有音乐，一 着的光鲜又得体，但同时感到自卑的你，发明出了阻挡雷雨天的科技，但同时将太阳天遮蔽，交流电代替了内燃机，从此家族再也不用手动去换挡。或许钢筋水泥才是我们对未来所期望的真正的幻想，我们用机械保护人类，人类同时为机械人站岗，没有人的电影院它不再播放，所以自然也不会再反复的散场。我观察大自然的现象，从太阳直到月亮，一切都那么的坚强，疲惫到抬不起肩膀，你是否能把我原谅，暂时把眼睛闭上，这座城市有我们的理想，但也是伤心的地方。 Tell me how you feel about the city, Tell me how you feel the night, Tell me how you feel about the city,Keep counting what you all time. Tell me how you're feeling about the city. Tell me how you feel the night. We're feeling about the city. So fascinating, but not差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，差不多，
爱奇艺悦享品质。
上课铃响，顶着太阳，听着领导演讲，头发长的都上来发展。那年秋天借给你的外套，留着淡淡你洗过的芳香。你的课桌仍刻着我的名字，你的模样却渐渐淡忘。天天年年月月开学，转眼到期末。迟早的，却不料已经到了。最遗憾不是离开你，是还没说出喜欢你。后座上静静的你，脑海里却是你。街灯亮起还不见你，该怎么才能留住你？讲台前回头的你，叫我怎么忘记你？啊！路灯闪烁，照亮青涩脸庞。大雨倾盆，有我为你撑伞。宁静夜晚，你在我后座上，多希望路永远走不完。曾经那样狂热，渴望成长，以为长大就能自由去爱。后来终于懂得那道理，渐渐明白为什么离开。朝朝暮暮岁岁，当少年已经长大，坐我坐下角的他，占据我心窝的他。最遗憾不是离开你，是还没说出喜欢你。后座上静静的你，脑海里却是你。街灯亮起还不见你，要怎么才能留住你？讲台前回头的你，叫我怎么忘记你？就看天空流云划过，肩头的心仍能在唱歌。你似水目光，像那天月光，完全是我心魔。别急，花开满了山坡，夏季的风融进眼窝，我已